Okay, so as I've said, you know, most of you guys know by now, everything in this truck, you know, this 86 d21 and all the steering, power steering components that I got on here now are from a 93 d21, and the 86 comes with the z24 engine. It's a four cylinder, but it's got the 8 spark plugs. And the 93 D21 has 4 spark plugs, and the engine is a KA24E, if I'm not mistaken. You know, obviously, everything bolts on, or most everything. Because I've been using this thing since I installed it for months without any issues. Everything's torqued and nice and tight and all that. This is the only on this bracket, the tensioner bracket. If you see this, hopefully you can see that. I'll get a better angle. That spot right there for a bolt is literally the only spot on this engine that there's no spot for that. That's literally the only part of this bracket that isn't bolted. But it has not in any way, shape, or form affected how all these brackets function, how they work. Or, you know, they bolt on to the block and to each other, and you know they're all reinforcing one another. But I'm gonna remove them all and then put them back in place just so that you can see that they actually go on. So I'll try to do this as quickly as possible just so you guys can see. And first thing is loosening this tensioner bolt. That way I can loosen the belt, take this pulley off, and that leaves me room to take the rest of the bolts off. And I'll get right on that. I can get this phone set up properly so you guys can see everything. Hopefully, it's not too. Hope they won't tip over or anything. I'm looking at, well, you probably can't see from your angle. Let me move this one again. In order to get this bolt off, we need to put something like so, put it in such a way that it's been a while since I did this. I gotta remember the exact proper spot for I don't want to damage anything else. That might work. I We shall see. And that's a yes. I don't need to involve much effort. You just want to remember, you know, keep everything organized, all your bolts and stuff, so you don't forget what goes where. Because I've done that a few times. And it's not fun trying to hunt down bolts. So, once we get this out, set it aside, I'm going to bolt the washer and this nut back onto the pump, just so that we don't lose track of them. To recall, these suckers are on tight. And the bolts that are actually hold down the brackets and the pump, those are 14 millimeter. The tensioner, at least the tensioner bolt that I was using, that's 10 millimeter. But again, like that's not the stock. That's not the stock tensioner bolt. I used that because the stock one snapped. It was old. So I'm actually, while I'm doing this, I'm going to install another one. I grabbed another bolt from just a random Nissan that was using the same system or pulley system as this truck. So I snagged the tensioner. Tensioner bolt and the little axle, I guess, that the pulley itself goes on, because they had the same thread. That particular bolt went to that particular one, so it's better to grab both parts and then come back and then not be able to bolt it onto this one. So yeah. It's been a while since I did this. It can get a little confusing, just a shade. I think the last bolt that holds down the pump itself is right down here underneath the pulley for the pump. with like a little red underneath it. Don't quote me. It's been a while since I did this. I don't know if you can see which bolt I'm talking about, but it's right down here. That should be the last one holding down the pump itself. Yep, looks like it. Saying that. There we go. And there's the pump itself. I just gotta set it aside a little bit. And now, okay, hopefully you can see from your perspective. There's three bolts. Let's see. Yeah, it looks like three bolts. This one, and this one that also holds down these ground wires. So, let me pause for a second because I gotta take these gloves off. They're getting really oily and dirty. So, I'll be right back. Okay, new gloves. Hopefully won't get all slippery. My mistake, wrong size. I thought they were all the same size. I was wrong. These three are different. It's odd. These three are 12. Huh. That's just odd. Making sure they fit. Don't want to go in there first. But you never want to force something in. If it doesn't go in, just take your time. You don't want to strip something or cause damage. It's weird that it's not going in with the, now it's in. And if you ever, when you're doing stuff like this, if you don't know how something goes, take pictures. So that way you don't forget how stuff goes. That's a good habit to get into if you haven't done a particular thing. We're not sure. And there's like a lot of moving parts involved. And you're not sure if you'll remember. Yeah, just get into the habit of taking photos. It'll make things so much easier for you. Okay, those are the last on that side, holding that portion of the bracket. The last two here, these two, hold this retentional bracket with the pulley pump bracket. They hold each other in place. So I just gotta take those two out. Might need a. Give me a second. These are both 12 millimeter, but this one's longer and thinner. This one's shorter and thicker. This is a naughty joke. Long and thin may go in, but short and thick does the trick. But anyway, we get a. Try to. Again, these suckers were on tight. See, she's almost already wiggling loose from those bolts being loose. Because this particular portion is a bit of a tight spot, it can be a little tedious to get those two nuts out, or bolts, I'm sorry, those two bolts, because you don't have a, you can't really use a socket wrench. There's not, I mean, you know what, yeah, you can, yeah, for at least for one of them you can. You just have to have a long extension. The lower bolt, it's tougher to get to. It's a bit of a tight space. Okay, you see the pump bracket, she's off, and on the engine part, you can see where each bolt, hopefully from your angle. There's one, and here's the other where they bolt up. Okay. And that means the last two bolts that should be on this are these two right here. Should be the last ones. Take those off real quick. Yeah, gotta use a wrench again. Because the pulley's in the way and I don't really want to take it off. That's okay. It's alright. Like I said, it's been a while. These were held on by nuts, not bolts. I mean, yeah, by bolts, but ultimately nuts. Get one last one. And that's that bracket, that portion of the bracket. You see that? Whoops. As you can see, the tensioner bracket itself. You know what? I do have to take this pulley off regardless, because I'm going to switch out this, sorry, out of focus, and take the pulley off so I can remove the, tensioner bolt. So I have a newer one that's not as long, and it's newer, not as worn out as this. So I'm going to pause real quick while I do that switcheroo and not, you know, take up more, video, because this is getting kind of long. Okay. So I got the new, tensioner bolt, and, it's the little axle that it goes onto, and the pulley goes onto. Here's the ones I was using before, which are older and longer, more worn out. This is probably several years young, newer, and in better shape. And you don't have to turn it as long to get that tensioner to where it needs to be. So now the follow the same process to put it back on. Don't forget, I was already reminding myself, but we remind myself, don't forget to use your thread locker when you're putting these on. See how easy it is to forget stuff? Had to put this bracket on first before those nuts. It's all good though. Better to catch your mistakes early on than at the end. So it's all good. That as you're putting, as you put your bolts and nuts on, don't torque them and tighten them on. Just put them on there snug. That way you can have the next bracket. Make sure it goes on evenly onto the next one, to the next portion. You don't want to have one part all the way completely tight and torqued down, and then you're having trouble putting the next portion on, or the next bracket on to that one, to the first one. There we go. Miss the obvious sometimes. What were those? 12. I just did that one thing I asked you guys not to. I forgot to put the thread locker on these. It's easy to forget. Hopefully that's in wire. Can't remember to put the lid to that. I'm so forgetful right now. What's up with this particular nut? Maybe it's got a... Oh, there we go. It's having issues. The pump itself can be a little tricky. It can seem like it's a little tricky, but sure, go on there. And again, with the thread locker, I almost forgot. Get the last three all at once. Last one. And as always, you want to be careful bolting these on. You don't want to over tighten them. I say that because sometimes I have a tendency to over tighten them, and I have snapped a bolt or two in the past. Speed this up. down to the last two bolts, or nuts, I'm sorry, the last two nuts. About getting the belt on. Oh, and then my fault. The pulley. And about this pulley. There we go. Trying to get the teeth to the still. Go. Now she's in the right way. And you'll have to do the same thing. Have a tension in there. So she doesn't move. So the pulley doesn't move, and the pump, because they're kind of free flowing. Thank you. tighten the tensioner pulley. Oops. You don't want to go too tight. But not too loose either. Show you that it's working. She's she trakes at a standstill. If I had the stock steering box or gearbox, whatever you want to call it, I would not be able to do this with one hand. I would need both, and I would have to seriously muscle it. This thing off. But yeah, just wanted to show you guys that it is possible. But again, other than this bolt, this portion of the bracket that you can't bolt down, that is literally the only thing that would keep anyone from putting power steering components from a 93 with a different engine to the 86 with the Z24 engine. Just that one bolt right there. And again, I've been driving for months and months like this, no issues, nothing at all. But if you do the same thing, I would just say be careful. Just be aware that bolt won't be on there, but as long as you torque everything down, put everything in the right way, all that good stuff, make sure your belt's on properly and all that, you should be good to go. Shouldn't have any issues. But again, always be careful. Don't just because I did it doesn't mean you should do it. You know, I was just showing, I wanted to show you guys that you can do it. But again, I just wanted to show this to you, and I will see you.